Immunosuppression is vital in organ transplants, but the drugs that dampen the immune system enough for a successful transplant also have significant side effects. At the University of Kentucky, Roberto Gedaly wants to shift the role of immunosuppression from drugs to the patient's own cells.
What we would like to do is we would like to create a novel form of immunosuppression using patients' own cells and get them reinfused in order to minimize the side effects from the compounds that are currently used for immunosuppression, or eventually stop the immunosuppression altogether, hoping that the patient will keep these organs for much longer. There's only 5 other protocols like this in the United States. This is probably the first in the state of Kentucky. I'm aware of only 12 other centers in the world using this technology to try to induce tolerance.
Of the more than 124,000 people on the national wait list for organ transplants, nearly 103,000 are waiting on kidneys. That's why this clinical trial will enroll 12 potential kidney transplant recipients. Gedaly's team will use the patient's own cells and special methodology to increase the number of regulatory T cells. Here's how it works.
We're going to send the patient to a procedure called leukapheresis. An extraction of white cells is the same machine we use when patients would like to donate blood. And we're going to do an isolation of high CD25 T cells, which are going to be these regulatory T cells, or Tregs. Those cells then will go to a special procedure when we're going to phenotype the cells to know exactly what they are. They have to have a special marker called FOXP3, CD25, CD4, and they have to be negative for another marker called CD127. Once we know their regulatory T cells, I'm going to put these cells in a special CO2 incubator, and we're going to expand them several fold in order to obtain appropriate dose, and then can be reinfused to the patients. The hypothesis is that we're going to be able to enhance the number of regulatory T cells in the circulation, which we think will enhance the number of regulatory T cells in the organ that has been transplanted, which will cause eventually immunosuppression.